You can display and update the value in a cell with your chatbot. From the previous scenario that we have created, we will add a new route. Select Google Sheets module and get a cell action. Select the same product inventory file. We will need to enter a cell ID here. But we haven't created the attribute yet. So let's go to chat view. Add a quick reply and name it cell. Create a new cell block. Go into the block, add a typing action and a text card, asking the user the action they want to do to a cell. Insert a quick reply and name it display cell. Save it to task attribute. After that, duplicate the delete block. And rename it to display cell. I will edit the text accordingly. Change the attribute to cell. Remember to insert the cell attributes in the JSON API plugin. After that, go to the cell block. Enter the block name that you have just created. Now go to the Google Sheets block, I will explain to you something. You may have realized that if the user select this cell quick reply, it will be saved to task attribute. And then over here, I have the same task attribute. So this display cell will override whichever value that was in the task attribute. Let's go back to Integromat. I will disconnect the module and run the scenario to send a sample data over. Switch back to chat view. Instead of clicking the link here, I'm going to set up an AI rule just to make my life easier. Add a new rule. If the user says something similar to restart, I'll bring them to Google Sheets block so I don't have to click on the link every time. Okay, let's test the bot. I will type in restart. And select cell. Display the cell. For the cell ID, I will use A2. Anyway, this is just a sample data. That's it, the scenario run was completed. It can receive the cell attributes now. Connect the router back. Select the product inventory. Now we can insert the cell attribute. After that, add another chat view module. We will display the result in text message. And set up a filter. Condition task is equals to display cell. Click OK when done and save the scenario. Let's go to Google Sheets. I would like to just display the shoe, which is in the cell B3. Now I will restart the bot. Select cell. And I would like to display a cell. For the cell ID will be B3. Yes, so that's how you display a value in the cell. Next, let's update the value in the cell. Let's go back to Integromat, create another row, and select Google Sheets module, and update the cell. We will need user input for the row number, column number, and the value. Let's head back to chat view. In the cell block, add a new quick reply action and name it update cell. Duplicate the display cell block. Rename it to update cell. I will edit the questions accordingly. Change the attribute to cell row. Add new fields. Save the answer to cell column. Then add a third field and save the answer to cell value. Remember to include the new attributes to Integromat. Next, go to the cell block. Remember to enter the block name here after you have created. Go to Integromat, unlink the module, and run this scenario once. Enter any sample data so that I can send the new attributes over. Once done, we can map the new attributes over. Select the same file. Then insert the new attribute that we have just created. Remember to set up a filter. Condition is task attributes equals to update cell. Let me just label it. Save the scenario and we test the bot. Restart the bot. Select cell. And update cell. I would like to update the back quantity. So for the row number, I will select 4. For the column number, initially I thought it's the letter C, but it is actually number 3, which is the third column from the left. So for A is 1, B is 2, C is 3. Enter a new value for the cell. Let's change the quantity to 19. There you go. You have learned how to display and update the value in a cell.
I hope you are having fun like I do when I first started integrating Google Sheets to my chatbots. You can do a lot of amazing stuff with what you have just learned. Before I end this lesson, I just want to share with you that at the end of every section, I may include a short quiz just to highlight some of the important points in the section in case you miss it. So I hope you can spend some time complete all the quiz that I've prepared for you. Thanks for watching, let's do some quiz and I'll see you in the next section.